I get all the time, if you save one life, and I'm like, oh, you know what? Well, that's not a very good value of Phillip's life to save one life. And you got 1,300 kids here today. What my goal is to hear is that we were all this age at one point, you know, peer pressure and so forth. And I hope the kids stand up to say, you know what? I'm not going to vape. I'm not going to Juul anymore. The new craze is going on. I'm not going to drink and drive. And there's going to be a percentage of kids here that have already got spent more time figuring out where they're getting their alcohol for tomorrow night, for the pre and post event, than they are where they're going to dinner or where what they're going to wear. So my goal is to get kids to say it's okay to be uncool and say, I'm not doing that. We found out about Phillip passing away by a yellow sticky on our front door on a Sunday morning. Police had sat out in front of our house 30 minutes, I guess, and we didn't answer the door. They left. And it was just to call a number in LaGrange, Georgia, and that's what started the flow of information that we knew that Phillip was dead. So I'm going to share that with these kids. There was a young girl in Auburn, a student that was T-boned, totaled her car. She wrote to us. She went back the next day. They let her get her belongings out of the car, and at the bottom of her floorboard was a Lutz E43 wristband that she had bought after Phillip passed away. She said, had I not had my seatbelt on, and I didn't wear my seatbelt before that, I may not be alive. So we see it. You know, Phillip signed off his Twitter signing with, I know God's working, so I smile. People want to give him credit for that, and that's a lyric from a Kirk Franklin song, I Smile, or called Smile. And he had a quote in there from Jackie Robinson that, you know, it's not important what I do on the field, it's how I impact lives. And to think that what he accomplished at age 23, I haven't accomplished at age 55. He was always adamant, even in high school, he got an ESPN top 10 play as a high school kid. And he's like, that's cool, but, you know, I'm not football didn't define who I am. So he really got it. But that's a powerful part of the message, right? Because even though he got it, poor decisions took his life. And that's what I'm going to impress upon these kids, because Phillip had everything going for him.